हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल टेक गुरु। प्लीज क्लिक ऑन द लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब बटन।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल टेक गुरु। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट मॉड्यूल्स इन पाइथन। Consider you are writing a Python program and you have written four functions like this, and consider each function is of 100 lines. It means total number of lines will be 400. It is such a long program. Now consider after some time you want to make some changes in this A function. So you are making changes here, but as a whole you have to debug the complete program. Debugging means finding out the bugs, removing the errors from your program. I have done changes in top 100 lines, but I have to debug the 400 lines. And moreover, finding out errors will be difficult in such a long program. So, for a better programming, can we divide such a big code into small parts? Yes, we can do that. Now, the benefit of dividing this whole program into smaller parts is that whenever I want to do any changes in this part, no need to debug rest of the part. I have to just debug this particular portion. Alright. Second, consider in future you are making a new project where you want to use the functionality that is given in A and D. So we can directly use them. We can call these modules here and we can use them. This concept is reusability. Alright. So friends, in this way, programming becomes little more easier and manageable. So friends, this process of dividing a big program into smaller portions is modular programming. And these small sections are called modules. So in this way, in Python, we can create different modules, and one module has coding related to one particular topic. So module is a file containing Python definitions, statements, or any valid Python code. That is a module. It can have functions, classes, variables, any statement that we write in normal Python program, we can write in the modules. In short, I can say a simple Python file that we have created till now, .py file, is a module. Now, what is the benefit of modules? Grouping related code into module makes the code easier to understand and use. When we make modules like this, it is very easy to find out the errors, debug the program, make changes, everything becomes more easier. And moreover, when I create different modules, I can reuse these modules into new programs. If I need functionality of this particular module, I can directly use it. So there are three types of modules that are available in Python. The first one is inbuilt modules, second is third-party installation, and third are user-defined. Inbuilt module means when we install Python, these modules are installed with that. So no need to do any special task for this. These are inbuilt. When we install Python, these are available to us. Third party installation means when we want to do some advanced programming, want to do a particular type of code, then we can install some more modules that are available online. We can freely download these modules on our computer and can use it. So these are called the third party installation. User defined means we can create our own modules. Alright, we can create modules and we can use them in our programs. Now let's see these modules one by one. Friends, to check the inbuilt Python modules that are available to our computer, first of all we go to command prompt. I click on start button, I type cmd. Now I write pip space list. Here pip means preferred installer program. This pip is used to install new modules It is also used to print the list of modules that are available in the system. Pip space list. Now I press enter. Look, it is showing there are two modules that are available to us. Pip version number is this and setup tools the version number is this. Alright. So these two modules are available in our system and we are already using these modules. Now the second one is third party installation. Friends, sometimes we have to do some special programming. We have to use some features that are already not available in the Python. It means some special directories or functions we have to include in our system. This process can be done by third party installation. There is a module or we can say package named Pandas. This particular package is used for data analysis in data science in Python. By default, this module is not available in our system. We have to install it. Let's see the process. How can we install a third party module? Simply go to cmd. Here write pip space install space name of the module that you want to install and see. Press enter. Look, it is downloading. Now it is installing. Look, it has successfully installed. Friends, Pandas is a module that is built on other module NumPy. I have installed it successfully. In this way, you can install any other third party package to your system. Alright. Now let's see about user defined modules. User defined module means we can create our own modules. Let's see the process. I go to IDLE. Now I create a new file. Here I am defining some functions. I have created a file and I have created four functions. I have given simple coding. You can write any other code in that. Now save this file. I write its name as calculate. Now click on save. File is saved. Now let's run it. Look, I don't get any output because there is no main in this program. I have not written any statement here. Alright. Now let's call this module in another program. So I go to file, new file. To import a module, we write import statement and then name of the module. Here I write one message in my module. Now I want to call this add function of calculate module here. So I will write calculate dot add. To call the subtract function, write calculate dot sub. Now save this file. Now let's run the program. Look, I got the output. What's happening here? First of all, this line is getting executed. This is my program. Then I write calculate dot add. This means I am calling add function from this calculate module, this one. So I am getting this output addition function. Then I am calling subtract function. So I am getting output from this function. So friends, in this way we can create our user defined modules and we can use them in our program. But don't you feel very boring to write the complete module name before the function name? Yes. Is there any other way to do this? Yes, let's see. The second way is write the module name and write as it's C1. Now this C1 will work as alias for this calculate module. So wherever I want to write calculate, instead of calculate I can write C1. So here I will write C1 instead of complete module name. I save the program, run the program. So look, I got the same output. Alright. Now, next method. Sometimes it happens that in a module we are having so many functions, but in another file I want to use only two functions. For example, here in calculate module I am having four functions, but I want to call only add and subtract. Then why to import the complete module? Is there any way that I can import only these particular functions in my module? Yes, that is possible. So I will change my statement. Instead of import, I will write from calculate import add comma subtract. Now the benefit of importing functions is that now no need to mention the module name before function. Now I can directly call them. Let's run the program. Look, I get the same output as I was getting earlier. Now the difference is that in previous two methods, these four functions were imported, but now only these two functions are imported to my mode 1 file. So I can use only add and subtract. If I write star here, star means I am importing everything that was available in calculate module. So now I can call multiply and divide also. I save the program. I run the program. Look, I am getting output of multiplication function also. So friends, if I write this from calculate import star, it means all the functionality that was available in calculate module that will be imported to my this mode1.py file. But this method is not recommended. Why? The reason is that how many functions we have in this calculate module, now all these functions will be member of my this file. So it means in future if I want to create a function with name div in this mode 1, it means if I say div, I write this and now I am calling this div. I save it, run it. Look what happened. We know that there are two div functions now. One that is defined in this module itself, and second that was defined in calculate module that I have imported. So two div functions are available here. When I call, the preference will be given to its own function. So this div will give the output, this will not give the output. But it is not recommended. That's why whenever you are importing any package, import using alias method or import by writing the function names. So friends, I hope this topic is clear. So thank you so much for watching my video. Please click on the like, share and subscribe button and keep motivating us. Thank you.